Current and target situation, the gap. In order to draw up a goods need analysis, we have to look at two situations, the current situation and the target situation. The current situation is where the students are before the course begins, and the target situation is where they are likely to be when the course ends. So the gap in between these two situations is what we call the training gap, and here is where the needs analysis falls. The difference, the training gap between these two situations, leads to the course design and ultimately to syllabus, methods, constraints, learning and strategies. So this training gap can be called basically establishing the need of the initial need of the course, and because of this gap which we have identified, or the initial need which we have identified, all the other decisions regarding the course design will automatically follow regarding the learner, regarding the learning situation, and regarding the language in which the learner is supposed to be operating. So first of all, we need to be very clear about whose needs are we talking about. Are we talking about the students' needs, or are we talking about the company's needs, or are we talking about the university's needs? So there could be the company's needs and the university's needs are also a very important factor here, because the student might be having his own ideas about what he needs, but the company, university and the sponsors who are paying for a particular training course, their needs are also very important to consider. Another thing is to appreciate the difference between the perceived needs and the felt needs. The perceived needs are basically of the other stakeholders in the learning process, the teachers, the sponsors, and the co-workers. They establish this need according to their own knowledge and their own experience. So perhaps they think that the perceived needs for a particular group of participants of a course is that by the end of the course, they would be able to negotiate with foreign investors. But the felt needs are from the learner's perspective, and perhaps the learner doesn't feel this, and he feels a more immediate need that he should be improving his grammar and his spoken skills. So another way of thinking about needs analysis, that we think about what and how we might teach. So this is basically the content and the methodology which is to be used. So the teachers might think of needs analysis as a list of products which they have to deliver in class, the what, the content of the course. And this might be a list of linguistic items, for example, it could be a list of grammatical, lexical items, or it could be some skill like giving a presentation or asking a question in a meeting and so on. And then it could be thought of as a process of delivery. How is it going to be delivered? What is the methodology which is going to be used by the teacher? And here it would be from the perspective of the learner. The teacher will need to ask himself or herself, what does this particular learner need to know? What methodologies should I use? What are the effective filters which I should consider? So like all language teaching, business English teaching also draws on both these perspectives. A needs analysis offers a chance to focus on those areas which are more relevant to the learner or the company. So it does not give us a clear-cut indication of what it is. It does not give us some clear-cut document about this is the needs analysis. It does offer a chance for us to focus on certain aspects, and it gives us a series of snapshots, none of which are very clear, but a collection of the snapshots which would perhaps aid to the understanding. Then it also gives us a justification of the needs analysis and to point out the difference between a business English course and a ESP course or a general English course. Because we say that the basic difference and the characteristic feature of a business English course, as of all ESP courses, is that it works on a needs analysis, which is not the case in the general English. So at some stage, we can give it as a justification. So we can say that essentially, The needs analysis is a blend of information gathering activities using a variety of perspectives, the teacher's perspective, the learner's, the sponsor, the company's perspective. And not only that, it also tells us how to interpret and use this data to identify target needs. Basically, the gap which we have identified earlier can be addressed by asking what knowledge and abilities will the learner need to operate with competence in the target situation.